your program.
Yes.
Briefly describe 9 pillars of this idea.
So 9 pillars, not be able to say 9, but I mean it is a comprehensive program where government is trying to.
Alright. Under this there is a program called BharatNet.
Yes.
Can you describe that?
Sir, this is National Optical Fiber Network, under which sir, the government is trying to connect the 2.5 gram panchayat with broadband connection, which has speed up to 100 Mbps. Okay. And sir, this is, most of it has already been in progress, sir. Around more than 1 lakh gram panchayat have already been connected. So the progress is going.
So how much total money is going to be spent on it? And has the UCM lakh have been connected, which is a correct statement. How many are left? 1.5 lakhs.
Sir, I am not aware about the latest figure.
Latest is yahi, jo aap keh rahe. There was a function organized in Delhi by this Ministry for Communication on 8th or 7th of Jan this year, where they stated that 1 lakh have been connected. They have even given rewards and recognized the services of certain states where it has been done. So, your statement is correct to that. But now, what is the next program? 1.5 more have to be released. So, what is the program for that? Any, have you read it?
Sir, I have not read the details as to what are the obstacles or is there any obstacle for that?
No, that program has been launched. In November, second phase has been launched. When will it be completed? By end of
2019.
19, correct. What would be the benefit?
Sir, the digital services of the government of India can be, sir, we can reach out to the gram panchayats. Sir, it can help us in telemedicine, it can help us in providing better education. We can use smart classes to give better education to the children of the gram villages. Sir, other services of the government, for example, ENAM can be connected and sir, the ENAM activities can be conducted through the panchayat itself. So, that can also be
there. Correct, you are correct. It is a program wherever there are deficiencies in service governance in villages. BharatNet is intended to take care of it. For instance, villagers will be given information about the best seeds, the best cultivation practices, right? Second is services like birth certificate, death certificate, your land holdings, that service will be there. Third, telemedicine. You know, doctors don't go to the hospital, to the villages. So there will be programs aimed for the, what is general hygiene, what is sanitation, etc. Fourth is classes. Teachers are missing from schools. So now, if programs can be beamed through this, then education will spread. These are some of the good things. Fourth is financial inclusion. Financial inclusion. These are some. Now, one more thing. You think cyber crime is a problem in India?
Sir, cyber security is a problem in India. So we need to strengthen that framework. More so because government is collecting this Aadhaar database for so many, so all the citizens.
So when cyber security is breached, does it become a crime?
Sir,
does it amount to crime? No?
Sir, under IT Act, there are some provisions.
Well, some countries breaches your cyber security,
yes, sir,
or some terrorist breaks it, your security, cyber security, does it become a crime?
Sir, because they are outside our jurisdiction.
Why don't you say it's a crime? Where is the harm in saying this?
It's a crime, but...
Is it a crime?
But I'm not sure if we can persecute those people.
So you are saying that cyber crime is not a problem, but cyber security is a concern. That's what you say. So cyber crime is not a problem in India, no?
Sir, it is a problem.
It is a problem?
Yes.
Now you are admitting it.
Sorry, sir.
All right. Then if it is, you are admitting, then can you give me some fake action figures?
Sir,
the NCRB data?
Sir, I do not know the details from the National Crime Records Bureau, but recently, sir, last year there was a ransomware attack where...
These are random attacks. You give a full picture.
Sir, I am not aware about the full picture.
I will give you a full picture. Between 2014 and 2016, 1,44,000 cyber attacks were made. by different individuals or by different agencies in India. Therefore, what is the government doing now? It is very concerned about these things. Cyber is talking of women, your account being hacked, money missing from your account, all these things are happening. So what is the government doing? The reports are coming in the last few days.
So the government has set up this cyber emergency response team. So it, for financial sector specifically, it created in last year budgets this cyber profile.
Have you heard that the government has decided to set up an organization for I4C? I stands for Indian.
So Indians,
4C means there are C, four letters C. 4C. Have you heard of this organization? Under the ministry, home ministry.
Sorry, sir.
No? Did you read the report today or yesterday? It came in the paper that it is so serious the problem that in Delhi police, it will be cyber crime will not be part of the economic offences wing. It will be a separate. There will be separate manpower under a special commissioner of police. So that is the enormity, and we must watch these. 4IC stands for Indian Center
Cyber
Coordination Center. Indian Center for Coordinating Crime, something like this, in 4C. And this will be a fixed body now under the Home Ministry, and they will set up. District wise, they will go because it is becoming. Then the training will start of the police people. Only police can handle this, no other organization. Anyway, Apuchan.
Okay, Mr. Tanmay, we have a border problem situation. Last year, Doklam happened. Doklam stand down. Would you call that a border dispute?
Sir, it was a difference in perception of border between China and Bhutan. Sir, it was not a direct dispute between India and China.
So what was this all about? Why did we send in our troops into that area in Bhutan? What was the significance for India?
Sir, the significance is that there is a Siliguri corridor which is located very close to this Doklam plateau. Sir, there have been attempts made by China to exchange this Doklam plateau in the past for some other territory of Bhutan, but that has not taken place. Sir, India has a treaty of friendship with Bhutan, where I think, sir, India is obligated to help Bhutan in case it faces any trouble from any other country.
External aggression.
Yes. So, sir, for that reason, I think India sent its troop to protect Bhutan from this aggression.
Yeah, but you're right. Primarily, the reason was security concern for India.
For India, sir.
Because it threatens our Siliguri corridor, which connects what?
So which connect our northeast to the mainland.
To the mainland. Now, we have another dispute with China on the issue of the China-Pakistan economic corridor. Why is that? Why are we so opposed to this?
Sir, it is passing through the Pakistan-occupied territory of Kashmir. And sir, it is our sovereignty issue. It passes through Gilgit-Baltistan and then it goes to Badr. So that is our territory. Our consent was not taken and this project was launched. So I think that is why India put up.
And what is the strategic importance of this CPEC for China?
Sir, it can mobilize its troop from Chinese part to the Pakistani territory if there is any conflict between are these neighbors are India and Pakistan, and China can actively participate.
That's the only reason. But they are already sitting in Tibet.
Yes,
the Chinese are already sitting in Tibet. They have got airfields there, not one, more than one. They have a train connectivity to Tibet, isn't it?
Sir,
and they are massed all along the Arunachal border, running across Sikkim. So, where is the question of troop movement?
Sir, the Gwadar port is also the end point of CPEC, so through which Chinese can influence our navy. So that is another aspect.
You are almost there, but you are not. Basically, you are right. Gwadar is the main issue because then it gives the Chinese an access into the Indian Ocean. Right. And what is the choke point which India can use against China?
So the Chabahar port that we are.
At what is the route which the Chinese follow for their
so the Strait of Malacca.
Correct. That is the choke point. So this is basically an alternative to the states of the dependence on the states of Malacca, because if Indonesia and India and others decide to choke them there, then at least they have a direct link to the Indian Ocean and then to further to Europe or Africa or Asia, wherever they want to. Right? Okay. Now we have another dispute on the Masood Azhar issue. Who is Masood Azhar and why is this problem going on?
Sir, Masood Azhar is a terrorist who was released when the plane hijack took place in Kandahar.
Yes.
Sir, India has put forward a proposal to declare him a terrorist. But
Where?
Sir, the UN Security Council should declare him an international terrorist. And sir, the Chinese are not agreeing to this. They are supporting Pakistan that he should not be declared as a terrorist.
Okay. Thank you.
You were a senior analyst with Goldman Sachs. So is this the Goldman Sachs bank part of it?
Yes.
So it's such a lucrative job, why did you give it up?
I liked the job, but I realized that I want to do something more satisfactory. I think that is why. So I left the job. I think, sir, when public service can provide huge diversity which is not there in this job. So.
Alright. So tell me, why are the stock markets always so volatile? You were dealing with the stock market? What is the reason for the volatility?
And it's the change in the demand and supply which creates volatility. Mm-hmm. The
what is change in the demand and supply? Anything else?
The events that take place daily, mm-hmm. they change the sentiments of the investor as to if the stock is going to go up or down, and then they trade accordingly, and then positive feedback kind of happen. If people are buying some stock, it will go up, and then more people will get attracted to buy it.
So if you were asked to choose three very important stocks today, what would you recommend?
I would not give
any... Not by name, but by different categories like pharma, like motor vehicles. What would you recommend?
I would recommend private sector banks.
Mm-hmm. They're not doing well.
Private sector banks are slightly better. I would recommend the pharmacy sector company and also some IT sector companies.
But pharmacy is having a lot of problems, especially with the US Fed.
Yes, ma'am, the IPR related issues.
Mm-hmm. Alright. So you also are into, you wrote a paper on information theory. Tell me something about this paper that you published.
Ma'am, it was a communication protocol mm-hmm. between multiple parties. The basic concept is that there is a server which is broadcasting some files
mm-hmm.
and there are, for example, Netflix.
Yes.
Let's say two users want to watch a film in Netflix.
Yes.
Then they would send their query to this database, and the database should not know that which user is watching which film. And the user should not know anything else apart from the film which they are supposed to watch. And this should happen even if the parties collude. So even if they try to share their information, they should not be able to make out anything more of it.
Alright. So do you think that social media is impacting our life?
Yeah, ma'am. Yeah, I think it is. And the social media, for example, it can create law and order problems as well.
Yes.
Some communally sensitive videos can be shared easily.
Mm-hmm.
It is also impacting in the way more people are able to express their views more freely. Sir, ma'am, independent medias are being set up.
What are your views on net neutrality?
Ma'am, I think that net neutrality is a good idea because it allows new companies to come in. There is a level playing field. The companies such as Google and Facebook, they have become so huge. And now, because of the net neutrality. So
does it benefit the startups?
Yes, ma'am, it benefits the startups.
Thank you.
Tanmay, you have mathematics as your optional subject and electrical engineering.
Yes, sir. Mathematics must be optional in this exam.
There is a debate as extension to right to privacy.
It is called the right to be forgotten on internet. What is this debate about? You have heard of right to privacy.
Yes.
Right. So what is this debate on right to be forgotten on internet?
Sir, I
have both pros and cons.
Sir, I have not heard about this.
You have not heard?
Yes. So
it's your privacy on internet. And how do you protect your privacy on internet? It is.
Sir, is it related to the data issues which the companies which are hosting these servers?
It is relating to the misuse of internet. Suppose some objectionable information is put against you on internet, how will you protect your right to privacy? I thought you will be well conversant on pros and cons of right to be forgotten.
Okay.
You come from Madhya Pradesh. Used to be a Bimaru state.
Yes, sir.
What is the present status?
Sir, there has been consistent growth in Madhya Pradesh for the past few years. So the agriculture sector was doing well. Last year there were some problems, but overall the growth rate was above the country's average. So it was growing rapidly as compared to other sectors. But its overall base is very low, so even after that growth, per capita income would be low for that state.
Any other parameters you would like to say about?
Sir, it is trying to protect industries, promote tourism sector as a potential for job creation as well as to generate more income. Sir, there are, so recently the government has released its defense policy to attract defense manufacturers in Madhya Pradesh. There are ordnance factories and various PSUs which are also there.
Okay. ITS is your second choice.
Yes.
As a policeman, would you promote and counter as one of the strategies that you have to deal with the situation, or you will take it as unethical and not support encounter? Have you heard of encounter?
Yes, sir.
And you also have heard as to under what circumstances and counters better. So as a policeman, what will be your strategy?
Sir, we should give the chances to criminals to surrender. But if there is a back off, for example, they start firing on our policemen. Sir, in that situation, sir, it becomes necessary to also allow our policemen to respond to that. So I would not promote it as a strategy to just go and encounter. But if the situation comes up where it is necessary for the safety of the people who are working under me, then I would take the positive action.
Can you say which state has got the largest solar power producing plant?
Sir, recently Telangana was the major one, and it took up, sir, it overtook Rajasthan.
It's Tamil Nadu.
Sorry.
The place is called Komuti.
Oh, the single largest place for
yes. Solar power plant highest production. This was there in the newspaper. You are a math student. So and you are interested in puzzle solving. If I throw a red stone into blue sea, what will happen to the stone?
The stone will go inside the sea.
Stone will sink. What is the golden ratio?
It is the ratio which is generally observed in the nature. It is the root of an equation.
Root of?
Sir, there is a quadratic equation and
what is that equation?
Sir, I am unable to recall the equation as well. But sir, it's around 1.6. It is close to 1.6. And for example, the shells that we see in the sea, the pattern is followed is in proportion of.
You think this ratio was ever used in paintings, in oil paintings?
Sir, it could have been used, I'm not aware about it, but since it occurs in nature, therefore it is.
So Leonardo da Vinci in his painting has used water.
Tanmay, infrastructure projects that have been a drag on the on our growth, right? Slow progress, and there are some implementation issues and all that. You have worked in a competency fund, right? How do you see this problem? And what can be done to speed up implementation of the infrastructure?
Sir, the road sector is performing well, sir. I read that the number of roads which are constructed have got its pace back. Sir, the issue is also, sir, that land acquisition remains a problem.
What is land acquisition? Okay.
Sir, the funding, we are not able to mobilize funding from the private sources because our, sir, the PPP model was not very successful, although the government is trying to bring in more funds from this, but that remains a concern.
Any other model being tried?
Sir, this hybrid annuity model has been tried, where the government pays the private company for a few years, and after that they starts the business operation would start, for example, toll connection in a highway project, and they will get their investment back from
that. Has also run into problems?
Yes, that has also run into problems. So the build, operate and transfer model is also there, where the government would ask a private sector to build these infrastructure projects and then operate it for a few years and then give it back to the government. So
apart from finance and also
land acquisition,
any other problem?
Sir, the banking sector is facing challenges, so I think the getting of loans from those, so the investment might not be flowing from
them. That comes under finance.
Yes, sir. Sir, the red tape is a
legal issues also.
The litigation.
Litigation.
Yes, sir. Sir, recently I read a report that in Arunachal Pradesh we are not able to electrify the remaining villages quickly because of the litigation issue. So that is a problem.
Slightly different subject, GST. There were implementation problems.
Yes.
And in the last meeting of the GST Council, steps have been taken to speed up. Are you aware of?
Sir, there was rationalization of rates for few items. There was proposal for e-way bill, which would allow the interstate movement of goods easily.
Any other advantages of e-way? How actually it is to be operative?
Sir, the traders will get this e-way through online filing of their whatever they are trying to trade, and the checking inspection would time would reduce there, so it will improve the efficiency.
Right. Okay.
Sir, apart from that, there is a decline in the GST collection which is seen in past few months after the first month. So that has, but for the month of December it has gone, it has become relatively better.
Okay.
So, sir, I am not aware about any other issue from the last GST.
Which are the items which are still kept outside the purview of GST?
Which are not part of GST, alcohol and petroleum, aviation turbine fuel, liquor.
Are they going to be taken up shortly?
Sir, it is the mandate of the GST Council to decide when will they be included in the GST.
Of these two, which one will be taken up first? In the next meeting or two?
Sir, alcohol, sir, there is debate regarding alcohol.
Petroleum will be taken.
Sorry, sir.
Not alcohol. How do you look at the relationship between the center and the states, how it has evolved over the years?
Sir, this development of GST Council is one positive thing for cooperative federalism.
My question is, how has it evolved?
Sir, the evolutions are, initially all the states were ruled by a single party. Most of the states were ruled by a single party, so there were good relations. But over the period, sir, regional parties have evolved. And they also look at their state issue.
States are being financially strengthened now?
Yes, sir. In the 14th Finance Commission, the total dispensation has increased to 42% from 32%. This is seen as a major improvement in terms of financial resources devolution to states. So that on the, in the finance side, so this is one improvement.
There is a demand by some people that in the administrative services, there should be lateral entry. People from the private sector should also be allowed to join the, to be taken in the civil services. First of all,
Sir, I think it is a good move, because if there are departments which require some kind of technical expertise that we can get from the private sector, which might not be available within the service, then...
Is this practice in vogue in any country?
Sir, in USA, the president appoints all his staff, the important positions. So, sir, because that is presidential, sir, it follows a different system. But such practice exists in other countries. Thank you.
Alright, we close your interview. I will give you a feedback. When is your interview?
19th March.
Thank you. So you have some time, huh? More than a month. Most of the questioning will be based on your biodata and on current affairs. So I would suggest you take a look, close look at your biodata and prepare yourself accordingly. When we look at the biodata, we feel, we say, mathematics is your subject, right? It was. Then you come from Madhya Pradesh. Third is you've done electrical engineering. And fourthly, you are doing research, computer science, etc. Right? These are some of the areas which will catch attention of the UPSC interview board. So they might start asking you questions. Mathematics, supposing they want to ask you some questions. Are there any new theories or advances which have come up in mathematics? Any? Can you think of it?
A prime number has been found, which is...
Okay, so you keep that in mind. I don't know, because I don't study mathematics. But I'm telling you that if any new things have come up, so that should be yours. Then there is some award for global award for mathematics, something like a Nobel Prize award. What is it called?
Fields
Medal. Yes. So that you can also check up which people have got it, for what purpose they got it. Last 2-3 years. This is about mathematics. ये मैं आपको इसलिए कह रहा हूँ क्योंकि इन चीज़ पे आपको ध्यान रखना है, कहीं से भी क्वेश्चन आ सकता है. लेकिन basically वो आपका biodata देख के कहेंगे. Second is Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh you were asked, Bimaru state. Why it has become so good? So you collect some good data. Primary things are 2 or 3, which Mr. Chauhan has done. Number one, agriculture has been in the forefront of development. Agriculture could reach up to a level of 13%. Indian is only 4%. They could reach up to 13% growth. Secondly, tourism has been increased to a great extent. Thirdly, the industry, they have invited industry. So in all these fronts, they have made lot tremendous progress. Therefore, it has come up among the one of the fastest growing states in the country. Then a related question could be, which are the other states which are doing so well? So you must keep this in mind. Madhya Pradesh, there is a Vyapar scandal. They may ask you, what is it happening? Why would happen? So keep that in mind. Next, we come to your papers on information theory, your extracurricular activities, you play cricket, you do cooking, they can ask you, will cooking help you, your knowledge of cooking help you in administration? What answer will you give?
So I would say that not directly in administration, so for example, it can help in midday meal scheme checking, if the quality of food prepared is
not said. Don't try to find some very deep meaning in your cooking. You just say it's a leisure time activity. Nothing more. Some people try to find something. You know, main aise masala dunga, itna itna, so I'll find some balance in my work. Don't create a theory out of cooking.
Stress master.
Electrical engineering. Power generation India ka kya itna hai? 320 ke kareeb hai maine. Solar par kitna hai? You were asked a question also. And you gave a wrong reply.
So I thought the total installed capacity, but the
total installed is about 12,000
megawatts.
Yes. So Tamil Nadu is in the forefront, about more than 2,500 megawatts. Okay. But there are Andhra is doing well. Madhya Pradesh is doing. Madhya Pradesh is
starting.
Riva Bagheera. It is going to be one of the biggest. And you read, day before, yesterday, Hindustan Times gave a full picture of development in Madhya Pradesh. You didn't probably miss that.
I didn't read this.
Alright, I'm giving you a hint. You can check up. Then physics is your subject.
It's not.
Actually, I was in 12th. It doesn't matter. Then computer science, digital India, you were asked, cyber crime, net neutrality, then current affairs, Doklam, CPSC, Masood Azhar, Goldman Sachs, you worked, so definitely you can be asked some questions on banking, etc. How is it when every bank was in a bad way in America in 2009, Goldman Sachs was doing so well? That can be a question. Social media, how its advantages, its disadvantages. Largest solar plant you were asked, Kamuthi you have been told. Highest solar estate, Tamil Nadu is still the highest. It could go to Wikipedia, they'll give you a table of this.
So I checked the Wikipedia, it said Telangana. That's why I mentioned it.
Which is the power plant in Telangana?
I don't know the power plant.
So you better check up. I'm giving you last year's information. Kamuthi came up last year for commission. 640 megawatt. It is considered one of the largest in the world, by the way. Center state relations. What is the state of infrastructure in our country? GST. What advantages? What disadvantages? Okay. Now budget survey has come today. Check out the budget survey. Budget will come. All these things will be of relevance to you. And things like ASEAN. World Economic Forum, what happened there. These are the developments on which you must focus attention from today. Every important piece of information you must keep some knowledge ready with you and read it again and again. This is the way to handle that. Alright? Yes.
Sir, apart from that, sir, the way I speak or
all that is
eye okay. contact,
everything is okay. You don't worry about these small things.
That is very good.
Sir, one question. Sir, the state of the relationship between center and state. So, what is that you were trying to look for in that answer? I could not. Sir, it appeared to me that I could not answer it.
Of late, you know, the states are, the financial position of the states are being strengthened. Exactly that. In the past, states were relatively at a disadvantage position. Center was rolling out money to the states, and the financial position of the states was not good. And that is now being rectified, and as you said rightly, the 14th Finance Commission, it enhanced the devolution of funds from 32% to 42%. Plus, you know, GST is also going to strengthen the financial position of the states. But the idea is that since they will be implementing the schemes and implementing the projects, it is logical that they should be given more funds. So,
the state
finance is a
matter. We can. Right. Basic thing is that earlier the states used to come with a begging bowl before Mr. Montek Singh Ahluwalia. Who was he, you know? Now it is cooperative federalism, Niti Aayog. So everything is being done in consultation, or largely things are being done in consultation with the states. That is why the word cooperative federalism. So chief ministers have a say now. In running their administration, how much money they should get. So, this is second is Finance Commission. Finance Commission has announced the allocation, as you yourself said. Second, now 15th Finance Commission has been set up because of the GST. After GST, what are the changes in the tax collection, etc.? What will be its allocation? Again, it will have an impact on the state center position. So, these are the things which you should say.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to never miss an update.